Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today is October 16, 2011. People, as y'all who follow me know, right? Yesterday, October 15th, I uploaded this video, right? October 15th, 1992 to October 15th, 2011. Death and Rise of God Star. 9/11 plot. LNA Nibiru schemes. And federal court. Okay, people. This video, right, is in response to that. In 1992, right, October 15, 1992, I was wrongfully convicted of attempted murder, right? And y'all should watch the video, so I won't have to go back into it. But the point is, people, right, on this day, October 16th, right, October 16th was the day they imposed sentence on me. See that? 9 to 12 years in prison. They gave me 9 to 12 for attempted murder, 9 to 10 for assault and battery, 1 year for the gun, 1 year for the bullets, okay? And they imposed sentence on me, convicted me for shooting someone who would have killed me. And people, for those of you who don't know the story, one of the guys who robbed me actually got killed by a cop a few years later because he tried to kill a cop. So people, he would have killed me. Wow, if my Lord wasn't with me, he'd have killed me because he tried to kill a cop and the cop shot him and killed him. Anyway, the point is, people, today, October 16th, they pronounced judgment on me. And you know, people, for the past couple of weeks or days, right, I told you all about my federal lawsuit, right, where my federal lawsuit for mortgage fraud, where the judge gave the bank my home just because I decided to fight for all the people. And I told you all that when I was in prison, I learned the law. And I used what I learned to come out here and fight the people. Y'all really should watch the other video. But the point is, people, they pronounced judgment on me on this day. And for the past week, I've been pronouncing judgment on Babylon. People, on October 8th and on October 10th, I released a video telling you all that they're gonna be it's gonna be a stormy month in October, right? I'm gonna show you, as a matter of fact, I'm gonna show you all the examples, right? Watch me predicting about these storms in the month of October. Then after that, watch the videos in the end, and you're gonna see my prediction came through, okay? And I'm not even finished yet. So people, I want y'all to be vigilant, okay? I don't mean y'all no harm, but I gotta cause Babylon money, okay? The system gotta be torn down, okay? Sorry, but y'all gonna have to take shelter, but we gonna tear down Babylon. Tear up your buildings, tear up the infrastructure, because that's the only way to weaken Babylon. So people, just be vigilant, okay? I don't mean you all no harm, but what is to be must be, because even if I wasn't here to do it, it would have been happening. Only that, it would have been worse. Laugh at me all you want, but consider me a blessing. And all those who love me, consider yourself a blessing to me also. So anyway, people, look at me predicting these storms, right? And then watch the storms materialize. So one love. So those who pronounced judgment on me 19 years ago, here's it back to you, okay? Here's it back to all of you. And you judge it in the federal court who pronounced judgment against me and my mom, said we commit fraud. Here's it back to you. Because guess what? The storms are wreaking havoc in Mr. Rothschild places. Because of your iniquity, the American government is going to have to pay to fix the damage caused by these storms that we are sending. So you see, I don't have to pick up guns. I don't have to cause the people to be violent against you. The storm will do, because this is not a war against the people. We're not trying to hurt the people. We're trying to destroy your infrastructure to show you that Babylon going down. Because Babylon is not the people. Babylon are your infrastructures. That's what it is, on your system. So we destroy you and your system. Just storms. One love, my people. So watch the video and know and understand who Paul Muckle is. Alright? One. Then that's what it will be. But you will not. Okay? You will not take me to here in peace. There's no peace. I don't want no peace. I want equal rights and justice. And I want Judge Woodlock and all the judges in prison. That's what I want.
Okay, people. Here comes the full moon. Prepare for some destruction this month, okay? In America this month. this October, okay? For because of Judge Woodlock and his first appeals court. Iniquitous ruling. Prepare for some destruction in America. Wow. It's out of my hands now. Okay. Okay. My Lord, I promise you I will never target this man, right? But guess what? You see Judge Woodlock? How would he feel when a lightning strike his evil heart? Huh? How would he feel when a lightning strike his evil heart? Huh? Yeah. They're gonna lock the freedom of speech because they're evil, these evil men in the First Circuit Court, these evil judges. Because of them, America about to reap some destruction. Because of these evil men in the First Circuit Court and in the District Court, because of these evil judges, some storm about to run through America. That's why Texas is burning. And that's why America is about to reap some more destruction. All because of these evil men in the First Circuit Court. Remember Paul McCartoli also, okay? Today, October 8, 2011. Paul McCartoli also. Some storm about to run through America. America and England, London City, where Mr. Rothschild resides. Okay. So people on Wall Street, if they don't kill me, I'll be joining you all soon, okay? I'll be joining you all soon. And believe you me, there ain't gonna be no surrender. If y'all come behind me, prepare to fight to the death. Okay? Prepare to fight to the death because this is a death match, okay? I'm gonna fight to the death. So if you all ain't prepared to fight to the death, don't even bother. Come near me, okay? Okay. I'm looking for soldiers who are ready to die. Ready to die for this country. Okay? I'm looking for soldiers ready to die for this country, not afraid to confront these judges and these banksters. That's what I'm looking for. We don't have to be no violence towards them. No violence. But believe you me, we're gonna get them. One love. Here comes my broadside. See y'all people see where it's at? Okay. Great side, right? Okay. Y'all know what's about to happen, okay? Judge Woodlock, I hope you're shaking in your drawers. Hope you're shaking. But my rara hunting you. My rara gonna be hunting you. The moon gonna be hunting you. And I'll be judging the First Circuit Court. Be very afraid. Be very afraid. The moon. He's gonna be hunting you all. Be very afraid. Yeah, they're in your hands, okay? Judge Woodlock is in your hands. And those other three First Circuit Court judges, you know who they are. They're in your hands, okay? Alright, deal with them according to how they dealt with me. Alright, one love. Let's see when you lose your home. Let's see when you have to tear your freaking roof off your house. Let's see how you're gonna feel. Let's see when you're sitting in a prison cell, eating off the floor. Let's see when you're doing that. Alright? One love, my people. Stay strong. The revolution has begun. And don't sell out, okay? One love. Okay, let's go to DC, my lord. DC tornado watch. There you go. There you go.
Damage like the ones we are. These are very well organized storms despite the month. And so that's what you need to pay attention to right now. Pay attention to the actual radar, the actual storms, not the fact that this might be a bit of an anomaly compared to what you would expect to see this time of year.
All right, let's go back to the radar on graphics 15 and take a look at what's going on internally with these storms.
Told you all, October is going to be a stormy month.
Still a pretty pronounced area of rotation. This is the 95 corridor right here. There's Occoquan. So it looks like this rotation is pretty much right over you in Occoquan and Woodbridge. You want to take cover immediately there. It's going to be coming out into Morton, maybe the Laurel Hill Golf Course as well. The movement is off to the north at about 30 miles an hour. Eventually, they get up towards Newington and Springfield if it does hold together. This is what we're looking at right here, this area where you see green and red kind of right next to each other. That's the area where the wind is coming into the radar and going away from the radar in a relatively small space. And that tells us that there is rotation in this parent storm, and there could very well be a tornado on the ground as well. Now, to the north, we do have some perhaps slightly better news in the Fairfax area.
No, Obama had it in the White House bunker yet?
A less well-defined area of rotation. It looks looks like there's still evidence of rotation there, but it's not as well defined as it once was. That is now coming up on the west side of Fairfax and getting over towards Vienna, Virginia. There is still now tornado warning in effect. That's going just for a couple more minutes.
Yeah, and this is the timeline of what we can expect for these storms as they continue to move on up towards the north and east at about 30 miles per hour. They will be in the nation's capital anywhere from, well, right now on the southwest side of the area to basically the National Mall in about 15 minutes, continuing on towards the north and east from there by around 7:30 into Columbia, and then continuing on in that direction. You can see that if these storms hold together, where they will go. But this is definitely something that we're going to be watching well into the
miles on the east coast
in order to keep everyone safe across the mid-Atlantic.
That's right, okay. And it looks like perhaps the more dangerous cell right now is the one to the south, the one that is now coming up through the 95 corridor. Take another look at it on the radar picture here, on the radar picture.
In the mid-Atlantic and the northeast, heavy rain, significant damage because of winds, and a tornado that hit the D.C. area. That was the biggest surprise of all.
Exactly.
Laying down.
There it is. For hundreds of Metro D.C. commuters stuck in rush hour traffic along I-95, this was the last thing on their minds.
It would bring over the truck.
A suspected tornado blowing by during their evening rush. The severe weather ripped through communities, slicing roofs off of homes and damaging an elementary school. And in a twist of fate, it's the same area that was hit hard by a 5.8 magnitude earthquake back in August.
I came home. I tried to go in my driveway and I seen the tree had fell over into the driveway. That's what caused all the lights to go out.
Across town, the severe weather found itself also on the guest list at last night's exclusive state dinner at the White House. The Obamas greeted the president of South Korea and his wife underneath umbrellas and heavy rain.
We're saturated, so that means fog outside. We have plenty of that light northwest wind, just enough to stir the air.
And as the wicked weather pushed into the northeast, Boston found itself shrouded in dense fog and nearly an inch of rain.
Mm-hmm. The wind came storming in and the power just completely went out immediately.
A drenching of a day along the eastern seaboard, and it's not over yet.
Y'all scared yet? What I told you all.
Not by a long shot. Is over weather right now. Well, very heavy rain falling for you here in portions of the northeast. There's your low pulling through the Great Lakes. We've got some issues for you today, especially from Virginia through New England. We're going to have heavy rain today. At times, you could see some isolated areas of severe weather. Much clearer, though, now down across the southeast. Storms have been coming through the Capital District and around Albany. It will just be a matter of time before more storms get going here in New York. But we've got some showers for you in around Hartford. As you look back into western Pennsylvania, heavy rain.
Federal court in Boston.
Ohio, you have the shower.
How about marching down there with a thunderstorm? Lightning storm.
In the upper peninsula of Michigan, through West Virginia, around Charleston, and as you work your way through Richmond, spiraling up through D.C. and Baltimore. Heavy rain for you this morning, so another nightmare commute in D.C., just like you had yesterday. New York, 71 today with showers, 69 in D.C. More clear skies come back out tomorrow. That includes New York and D.C. in the 60s. Same cannot be said for Syracuse and Pittsburgh. Your temperatures held back into the 50s and 60s. More rain for you yet near the lakes on Sunday. Dry conditions along I-95. Into the Midwest, it's a mixed bag for us here. 59 in Detroit today, Cincinnati at 68.
I'm not finished here. What did I tell you all? Next October is going to be a stormy month. And people in Washington, D.C. and Virginia, blame Judge Woodlock. I'm trying to get to South Carolina where Nelson Mullins' office is at. Nelson Mullins, those are the lawyers that represent Wall Street. But Nelson Mullins, the attorneys are ex-governors. They're all ex-members of the United States and state government. They are ambassadors, senator, ex-governor, head of the Small Business Association, former head of the United States Education Department. People, these are lawyers, okay, who are fighting against me. The most powerful lawyers of Virginia, South Carolina, North Carolina, D.C. area, Atlanta. That's where the offices are, and downtown Boston. That's where the offices are, and that's where I'm going to target. So I'm Nelson Mullins. Prepare, okay? I'm hunting you guys. I'm hunting you with my storms, okay? All right. You have been warned. I'm hunting. I'm Illuminati hunting.